Hello, I am Dada Patil. Let us see a topic, practically understanding determinate and indeterminate structures. We know that determinate and indeterminate structures are used extensively in the field. Therefore, designers must be aware of the difference in the behavior of determinate and indeterminate structures. This will help to anticipate problems that might arise during construction or later when the structure is put into service. If a determinate structure loses a support, there will be immediate failure. Once again, let me repeat, if a determinate structure loses a support, an immediate failure occurs. This happens because the structure is no longer stable. It loses its stability. During 1964 Niigata earthquake, a bridge collapsed. This was due to the fact that it was composed of simply supported beams, which were determinate in nature. Yeah, this is a photo showing the failure. Photo shows the collapsed bridge in Niigata earthquake. Earthquake caused the structure to sway. In each span, the ends of the beams that were supported on rollers, that is simple supports, slipped off from the piers and they fell into the river or the water. Very, very importantly, had the ends of the girders been continuous or connected, that is, if the structure would have been indeterminate, then the bridge in all probability would have survived with minimum damage. Since each span was simply supported, that is determinate, therefore the bridge collapsed. In California, similar simply supported highway bridges collapsed during the earthquake. And therefore, design codes were modified to ensure that bridge girders were connected at supports, thereby making it an indeterminate structure. An indeterminate structure has always alternative paths existing for loads to be transmitted to the supports. In an indeterminate structure, loss of one or more supports can still leave a stable structure as long as the remaining supports supply three or more reactions or restraints which are properly arranged. Loss of a support in an indeterminate structure can produce a significant increase in stresses in certain structural members. This can lead to large deflections or even to a partial failure which occurs locally. However, a carefully detailed structure which behaves in a ductile manner may have sufficient strength to resist complete collapse of the structure. A damaged, deformed structure may no longer be functional, but its occupants can probably escape injury. Now, if roller at sea, this roller at sea in this figure A is lost, that means if we remove this roller, still the stable determinate cantilever beam remains as shown in this figure B, that this is a hinge. This is roller, this is also roller. We have removed the roller at sea, but still this beam doesn't become unstable. It only becomes determinate. Originally it was indeterminate here. Now a roller at sea is removed, now it became determinate, but it doesn't become unstable. Alternatively, if we remove support at B, here figure C shows that the roller at B is removed, but still it results into a stable, simple beam. Indeterminate structures are stiffer than determinate structures, even though they are of the same span. This is due to the additional restraint supplied by the extra support. Let us compare the magnitude of the deflection of two beams with identical properties, that is, this beam in figure A and beam in figure B. Midspan deflection of simply supported determinate beam is 5 times larger than that of indeterminate fixed end beam. Here this beam in figure A is simply supported here, and the central deflection here by any of the methods in structural analysis is given by delta equal to 5 by 384 WL raised to 4 upon EI. Whereas, if we compute the central deflection of the same beam with the same material, same span, same cross sectional area, and the same loading applied, that is UDL throughout, but here the ends are fixed instead of simple supports, and the deflection is only WL raised to 4 upon 384 EI. That means the central deflection for this simply supported determinate beam is 5 times greater than that for the indeterminate fixed end beam. It is interesting to know that vertical reactions for this beam as well as for this beam, they are same, that is WL by 2 and WL by 2, and that is obvious also. But it is interesting to see that in fixed end beam, the negative moments, this MB and MA, which you call it as fixed end moments at the supports, reduce the vertical displacements produced by the applied load, and therefore the net deflection at the center for the fixed ended beam is less than that for the simply supported beam. So the simply supported beam is statically determinate, whereas that this is statically indeterminate. Indeterminate structures are more heavily restrained than determinate structures. Support settlements, creep, temperature change, and fabrication errors may increase the difficulty of erection during construction or produce undesirable stresses during service life of structure. Now let us see one more example. There is this girder AB which is fabricated too long, or it increases in length due to temperature rise. So here there is support at C, but this girder AB is fabricated either too long or it increases in its length due to temperature change. Now bottom end of structure will extend beyond the support at C, and therefore this bottom end of the structure will not be connected at C, it will go beyond C. Using jacks or other loading devices, the field crew, that is the people working on the field, must deform the structure in order to erect the structure until it can be connected to its support. Therefore, in erection process or procedure, members will be stressed. That means when this member has to be connected at C, it has to be done using the jacks or other loading devices, and while doing so the members will get stressed. This AB and BC member will get stressed, and it is interesting to see that reactions will get developed even when no external loads are applied to the structure, because here the structure is indeterminate. There is a hinge here as well as hinge here. So the stresses will be produced when the erection procedure is done. For this presentation, I have referred Fundamentals of Structural Analysis book by Kenneth M. Lead, Chia Ming Yuang, and N.A.M. Gilbert. Thank you very much.